do they think? Pump it louder, come on, don't stop and keep me going. Do it, let's get it on, move it.
Come on, baby, do it.
I am Amirah Fakhira. The hot issue is Bumiputera student issues in Malaysia. In terms of UITM, MRSM, employability and quality of graduates, and attitudes and behavior. Monday, 4 January 2021. In Malaysia, by convention, it is generally considered that all Malays are Bumiputeras. This official definition, which is widely used in Malaysia, whereby it taking up ethnic Malays and other indigenous ethnic groups, such as Orang Asli in Peninsula Malaysia, and the tribal people in Sabah and Sarawak. For Bumiputera ranking, largest group of Malaysia consists of three races, which is Malays, Chinese and Indians. Orang Asli are the native in Peninsula Malaysia are divided into three major groups, which is Senoi, Negrito and Proto and Proto-Malay. The issue is, UITM is Bumiputera rights, hak Bumiputera. Before we go more further about the issues, let's take a look at the history of UITM.
In 1956, Dato' On Jaafar has established RIDA, known as Rural and Industrial Development Authority Training Center. The opening of RIDA itself is focused to help the rural Malays at that time. After 10 years, the name has changed to Maktab Mara. After not so long, it changed to Institute Teknologi Mara, called as ITM. Since that time, it has grown into the largest higher education institution in Malaysia, as we familiar with University Teknologi Mara, UITM.
At their first establishment of RIDA, the main focus has been mentioned where at that time, our country had been attacked with British. Therefore, Dato' On Jaafar came up with the idea to have rural Malays that left behind in socio-economic factors. Until now, standing of UITM with numerous of branches in Malaysia with only Bumiputera students.
UITM has embarked on 5-year strategic plan, UITM 2025, which is expected to transform the university into a globally renowned university. UITM 2025 is a 5-year from 2020 until 2025 framework document which will outline the university's transformation agenda as it aims to become a leading global university of science, technology, humanities and entrepreneurship by 2025.
Although the plan aims to make UiTM a world-leading university, UiTM maintains its status as set out in Article 153 of the Federal Constitution, an institution specifically for the Bumiputera. This plan is an enhancement and value addition to the current development and needs of higher education. I will pass to reporter at Awani Studio about no rush to open quota for non-Bumiputera.
Baik, kita kembali semula dalam buletin Awani. Belum sampai masanya Universiti Teknologi Mara, UiTM, dibuka kepada semua kaum. Itu pendapat Ahli Parlimen Lembah Pantai Ahmad Fahmi Mohamad Fazil ketika ditanya mengenai cadangan untuk membuka institusi pengajian tinggi itu kepada semua kaum.
Jadi, saya lihat belum ada keperluan untuk membuka, kerana bagi saya yang kita perlu usahakan sekarang adalah reformasi di peringkat asas bagi pendidikan. Dan ini melibatkan satu perubahan yang agak mendasar dan perlu diberikan keutamaan.
Thank you, reporter from Awani Studio. Ahli Parlimen Lembah Pantai Ahmad Fahmi Mohamad Fazil did mention no rush to open UiTM to all races. First thing first, it is to take a look at the system UiTM. Government needs to be firm toward all those systems before open to others, which is not only focused to Bumiputera. Maybe in terms of sensitivity of aura living in same hostel, the fee that students need to pay. If UiTM has open to all races, the fee of UiTM also need to be changed or maintained. If there is a changes toward fee, so Bumiputera still has hope to get help from this study platform again? That is the question. Next, I will pass to reporter from RTM Studio.
Berdasar pengambilan pelajar yang hanya melibatkan Bumiputera, tidak akan diubah Universiti Teknologi Mara UiTM bagi semua kursus yang ditawarkan.
Jelas Naib Chancellor-nya Profesor Emeritus Datuk Dr. Hassan Said, langkah tersebut tidak pernah menghalang UiTM menyumbang kepada ekuiti perpaduan negara sejak penubuhannya.
Sifatnya kita lihat bahawa UiTM Datin telah memberi impak yang besar pada sosial Bumiputera, dan bukan itu saja tetapi untuk penyatuan bangsa Malaysia. Kerana kita menyumbang kepada kita dalam istilah equity for unity. Maksudnya equity itu penting untuk menyatupadukan bangsa kita.
Thank you, reporter from RTM Studio. UiTM Vice Chancellor Prof. Emeritus Datuk Dr. Hassan Said has stated that UiTM is only for Bumiputera students, and even though it never stopped giving an equity toward harmonious country. Affirmative action was introduced in 1971 when it became clear that Malays, the majority in the population, held only 2% of their country's wealth by year of colonized British. Affirmative policies by allowing only Bumiputera students to UiTM are nothing new, as it has been stated in UiTM Act 1976. When talking about the welcoming non-Malaysian students to UiTM, it is the strategy to bring along the name of UiTM in the world, based on the vision and mission UiTM. While previous PRO Chancellor UiTM, Tan Sri Dr. Arshad Ayub, has said about the UiTM perception, let's move to Awani Studio.
Baik, persepsi bahawa Universiti Teknologi Mara UiTM itu sebagai hak bagi orang Melayu dan Bumiputera adalah tidak tepat. Bekas PRO Chancellor UITM, Tan Sri Dr. Arshad Ayu menegaskan tujuan asal penubuhan UITM hanya untuk membantu golongan Melayu dan Bumiputera yang miskin dan ketinggalan. Dan kini, keadaan sudah berubah.
Apa abang ada haram lagi? Pada saya, Nur, pada saya tidak ada haram lagi. Cepat dah mula itu asalnya untuk membangunkan orang Melayu. Pasalnya apa? Keadaan dia kekurangan. Tapi pada hari ini masih ada orang Melayu kekurangan.
Dalam pada itu, Arshad mengesyorkan kemasukan UITM dibuka kepada bukan Bumiputera dan pelajar asing untuk kursus pengajian pasca siswazah. Jelasnya, sudah tiba masa graduan peringkat pasca siswazah di UITM mendapat pendedahan dan berani bersaing dengan kaum-kaum lain.
Thank you, Awani Studio. Previous PRO Chancellor UITM, even though he accepted the idea of accepting non-Bumiputera into UITM, he wanted to emphasize that only open to the non-Bumiputera in master degree levels. In this level, postgraduates can compete with each other with healthy competition and being an open mind graduate. MDAB focused to reshape the native child's destiny in UITM. Programs that call Mengubah Destiny Anak Bangsa was suggested by our Prime Minister, Datuk Seri Muhammad Najib Tun Abdul Razak in 2010.
The suggestion of Prime Minister Malaysia is aligned with university philosophy, which believes that every individual has the ability to attain excellence through the transfer of knowledge. In the other words, to help the less fortunate but able to learn. The focus is same, where to help Malays and Bumiputras to further their studies and at the same time to increase the socio-economic of Bumiputera. Through these programs, Bumiputera student from poor family and did not have enough great achievement to enter the diploma courses are given a second chance to improve themselves before they can enroll to a diploma courses upon the MDAB programs are successfully.
That's all from Kajang Awat Lani Studio. Continue watching Hot Issues from Nur Farah Nadhirah at Kota Damansara. Thank you.
Thank you, Amirah. Now I'm currently here at MRSM, or also known as Mara Junior Science College. So as we can see that we already know that MRSM also is a boarding school. Usually, as we all know, that way back was for Bumiputera's students. But nowadays, as we already know, that it's being open to every one of non-Bumi students to also enroll in this program, which is MRSM program. So from here, we have known that the first MRSM was established during 1972, February, where the first one was in Seremban. And now, this one is the siblings of the MRSM schools. So then, but way back was mostly male students, but now they already widen up for males and even females, and also Bumi and non-Bumis. So we can see that non-Bumis issue are a very, very sensitive issue when it comes to UITM. But what about in MRSM? So let's get to it. These are the programs in MRSM education system. Number one would be Premier, number two would be Bitara, the third one Ulul Albab, the fourth Dual Certificate IGCSE, the fifth one IB MYP, and the last one would be Technical. The total number of colleges are 54 colleges.
So 27 premier school is a national curriculum along with the MRSN curriculum that includes character building, development soft skill, and even entrepreneurship. While there is 3 numbers of college for Bitara program, where they cater high academic achievers mostly by applying the gifted and talented students in education approach, which they focus on students' development and even potentials. 5 number of colleges for Ulul Albab, where they integrate national curriculum focusing on STEM also with an Islamic study, including Tahfiz Al-Quran. As for dual certificate IGCSE, there is 15 colleges where they offer both Cambridge IGCSE and also the national curriculum for the secondary education. There are 3 colleges for IBMYP program, which they offer the national curriculum using the middle years program and the international baccalaureate framework. For technical program, there's only 1 number of college where they offer the same thing like TVET school. But for the lower secondary level, they will be introduced with robotic engineering. As for the secondary higher level, they will be introduced by mechanical engineering or electrical engineering, or even electronic engineering. So these are the location of 54 MRSM in Malaysia. But the main issue is to open up to non-Bumi students to enroll into MRSM or any school, which they said that it was a privilege to the Bumiputera student. But MRSM is the same thing as matrix, where the quota have been given to the non-Bumi for only 10%. The Bumiputera was given 90%. This is also one of the reasons why PKPIM, Persatuan Kebangsaan Pelajar Islam Malaysia, was questioning why do they need to open 49 Bumis for 10%, where most of the students with the SPM result are very good. Some take it with open heart, which is they accept only 1% of quota for the non-Bumi into the MRSM. Even our Minister of Rural Development, Datuk Seri Rina Mohamed Harun, even stated that they will be accepting 10% of non-Bumi in every MRSM, mostly to the B40 categories. This issue on opening to the non-Bumiputera students have been a huge debate or even issue or topic ever since 2002, when they have decided to open up to non-Bumiputera students into MRSM. Some of them agrees and some of them are not. There are requirements for the students to enroll into MRSM. They are being selected based on their academic achievement, personality and character, and even their involvement to curriculum activities. Priority will be given to applicants from the bottom 40% of the household monthly income, or as known as B40. Other than that, these are the requirements needed for every student. They need to be Malaysian citizen, one parent must be Malaysian citizen, must undergo national curriculum and PBS, including UPSR, PT3, and they have an interest in MRSM, but most important is their parents should be Malaysian, one of them. For Bumiputera students, take this golden opportunity and treasure it on improving oneself. Don't ever take it for granted. When there's competition within the non-Bumiputera and Bumiputera students, it is actually healthy. There's a lot of other issues that can be discussed or focused on other than this. That's all for MRSM non-Bumiputera issue from me, Farah. So now I'll pass to Siti Nurul Aina at Sepang.
Thank you very much for the live report from Selangor. Hello, Assalamualaikum and Salam Satu Malaysia. I am Siti Nurul Aina, live report from Johor Bahru. So, from the previous segment, we can see that Bumiputera students' issue became a hot topic in our education nowadays. And it mostly covers students from UITM, MRSM, and also the matriculation. there's so much privilege given by the government to Bumiputera students, especially those students at the higher institution level. However, some issues have arisen regarding the attitude and behavior of some Bumiputera students that could deteriorating the image of Bumiputeras themselves. So in this segment, I will give an explanation on attitude and behavior of Bumiputera students towards education. Firstly, we look at the definition of attitude and behavior. They sound similar, but actually they have different meaning. Attitude refers to a person's mental view regarding the way he or she thinks or feels towards someone or something, while behavior refers to an action of an individual that occurs in response to an event or stimuli. Basically, attitude is what people think or feel that lies on a person's mindset, while behavior is what people do or act that shows the outward expression of attitude. These two terms correlate to each other to represent both a person's view and action. So today, in this 21st century, the situation of our education has changed from back then. There has been an educational democracy where everyone has the right and opportunities to study at the higher institution level. With thousands of IPTA and IPTS students, there is no longer the privilege for the Bumiputera in the education because students from other races have access to it. Even today's education becomes more flexible. Either students want to enroll for full-time or part-time mode for specific program. We can see that the opportunities open widely to Bumiputera students to further their studies after secondary level, which have three ways to continue, whether at the undergraduate level, either STPM, matriculation, or diploma. However, there's a mindset of majority of Bumiputera students where they thought stepping into university level already proved that they have succeed in life, despite the fact it is not. Being in the university does not mean that we will succeed in graduating with excellence and getting job as easily as 40 years ago. 3 or 4 years of learning process at university will determine whether we gain excellence or failure. It depends on the efforts, attitude, behavior, and also learning strategies practiced by the students. Based on the observation and research, we found that nowadays there is a lack of number of Bumiputera graduates with first class honor who has CGPA of 3.50 and above. The pace they can achieve is second class honor among most of them. Many authorities gave their view that this situation occurs due to the weakness of Bumiputera students themselves. According to Sarok 2001, their inability to compete with students from other races is a reality in most higher institutions. Many believe that this is due to their attitude and behavior in learning. Their failures in getting good grades were believed caused by their laziness. Our former Prime Minister, Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad, said that most Malay students lack in academic achievement behind students of other races because they do not work hard and do not pay attention in learning. Other research also revealed that students do not have a high mastery of quantitative fields in mathematics and science subjects. This has raised an issue of Bumiputera students who have low interest towards science, whether in primary, secondary, or tertiary level. It also found that the number of Bumiputera students enrolled in science streams is reducing in number. Apart from that, learning methods used by the Bumiputera students are not systematic and consistent. This is because they usually study just to pass for an examination or test. Bumiputera students are said that they just take easy on studies that cause them to revise the study in last minute, especially when the examination is around the corner. They also only do work after some enforcement from others that might be their parents, friends, teachers or lecturers. This behavior is suits with the idiom, like a chisel with a hammer, or in Bahasa, we said bagai pahat dengan penukul, because these students only do work when instructed by others. Thus, this behavior would affect the quality of their works compared to the other races. On the other hand, Bumiputera students are said lack of motivation and lack of competitiveness among them. We could see the culture of Bumiputera students itself. They are less studying but more and love to enjoy. They have more time to watch television, playing games and hang out with their friends. We could clearly see that Bumiputera students spend more time chatting in the class or library compared to studying. This situation is different from most of non-Bumiputera students who are fully focused on their studies while studying. According to Abdul Samad 2010, Bumiputera students do not have clear goal in life if their parents or other people do not do it for them. They are also seen as not dynamic and unwilling to compete and like to take easy access on their learning. Besides that, Bumiputera students are also said to have low self-confidence and easily get involved into negative culture. According to Hassan 2012, the issue of absenteeism or skip classes is a culture of Bumiputera students. As a result, these students have low mastery of knowledge because they depend on their friends' and lecturers' notes without critically understand what they learn. This will contribute to the lack of intellectual mastery by the Bumiputera students. Thus, they would be irresponsible, ignorant, and does not take into account what is happening around them. This situation also makes them left far behind compared to students from other races. Most of them also involves in social things such as melepak culture, smoking, bullying, and so on. Other than that, Bumiputera students are said that they do not attempt to face the pressure of studying at the university. We know that the world having crisis on COVID-19 pandemic, yet some of Bumiputera students express their feeling through social media about the hardship they going through in online learning. We know that everyone undergo their own hardship, but the issues that have gone viral through social media worsen the image of Bumiputera students. And this is maybe the reason why many label that most Bumiputera students is spoiled students. We see that there's many advantage and privilege given by the government for Bumiputera students. They have the speciality as Bumiputeras, but some of them didn't use it wisely. So, upon this negative attitude, is it really represents the figure of Bumiputera students? The rising issues about spoiled students, do you think that contribute to the statements of Malays are lazy? If we just look at the negative side of something, we won't go anywhere. So, let's take a look to the positive side of Bumiputera students. There's a peribahasa which is, kerana marahkan nyamuk, habis kelambu dibakar. Just because of we see there's so much negativity in someone, we just close an eye for the good that they do. From this peribahasa, we can see that not all Bumiputera students have these negative attitudes. Nowadays, many of Bumiputera students has proved that they also have quality just like students from other races.
they work hard to achieve what they want, they also still possess a good attitude towards society. And most of them also lives up to the name of Malaysia to other country. To summarize, this attitude and behavior of Bumiputera students are seen clearly through their action, achievement, and so on. It depends on individual on how they view someone's action, but they have to bear in mind that every negativity could change if someone go to an extra mile. Next, we move to the live broadcast across the South China Sea. I am Siti Nurul Aina, reporting from Johor Bahru. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, Aina, from Johor Bahru. Assalamualaikum and good evening, everyone. I am Mohd Norzafri, Mohamad with my report from Sarawak regarding the Bumiputera employability and graduates' quality. As we always heard, the term like Melayu Malas, not competitive compared to the other races in job market in Malaysia. So, is it true? So, as mentioned in a Journal of Asia Economic, discrimination in high degrees, race and graduate hiring in Malaysia by researchers in University Malaya UM and University Kebangsaan Malaysia UKM, which said that Malay graduate get a callback rates lower in all the companies ownership of the Chinese nation, foreign and Malay companies, as reported in the study. There are a number of companies belonging to the Malays in favor of applicant Chinese compared to Malays. This is might due to the negative perception of the employers toward the Bumiputera job applicant. This study also shows that there are discrimination on Bumiputera job application, where the Chinese resume application get an interview higher by 22.1% compared to resume of Malay applicant, which only 4.2%. Researcher explain it is might due to negative impression of the employer to Malay applicant because of non-Bumiputera employer are more likely to think that Bumiputera graduate have lower level of education, productiveness, and they get a better chance in the public sector due to Bumiputera privilege specialty. Next, the study reported that the Bumiputera workers are less cultural compatibility and multilingual ability. A company needs an employee with skills and experiences, thus they are looking a permanent staff or employee to run the position in their company to get a greater productivity and profit. Employers face a situation where the Bumiputera employee are less likely to take up a job offer or simply quit within just a few months after being offered a position in their company. This indicates that the Bumiputera or Malay graduates have a tendency to feel uncomfortable in the workplace environment of multinational. From that, the non-Bumiputera employers less likely to take Bumiputera applicant in their company. The other reason why Bumiputera graduates and job applicants fail to get employment is due to lack of English proficiency. A big company would have multinational network with foreign country that require English as a primary language in their business and official affairs. So from here, Bumiputera graduates or job applicants are recommended to improve their English as a second language, while the ability to speak third language is a bonus that could highly put Bumiputera graduate and job applicant being super competitive in Malaysia job markets. So, from all of that point, is it true that Bumiputera graduates and employability market are not competitive and less quality as most of the others' perception? Let's find it out.
Ogos 1999, satu lembaran baru telah tercipta buat seluruh warga institusi keramat ini apabila ITM telah diangkat tarafnya menjadi sebuah universiti awam di Malaysia yang dikenali sebagai Universiti Teknologi Mara atau UITM. UITM secara tidak langsung telah membuka lebih banyak peluang kepada anak-anak Melayu dan Bumiputera untuk menimba ilmu dalam pelbagai bidang, bersaing dan standing dengan kaum dan bangsa lain. Kini, Universiti Teknologi Mara telah mengorak langkah dengan mencetus ledakan kejayaan bukan sahaja sebagai sebuah universiti yang terulung di Malaysia, bahkan terkenal di arena antarabangsa. Kejayaan UITM bukan sahaja diukur dari segi kecemerlangan pendidikan, bahkan kini telah mengembangkan sayapnya dengan mempunyai sebanyak 12 kampus cawangan di seluruh negara, 22 kampus satelit, 26 fakulti, 6 pusat akademik dan 500 program akademik dalam pelbagai bidang tujuan. Setelah 60 tahun mendukung objektif perubahannya, peranan UITM kini menjadi bertambah penting dalam pembangunan dan kemakmuran negara, selaras dengan misi dan visi UITM untuk menjadi sebuah universiti unggul berteraskan kesarjanaan bagi menerajui dinamisme Bumiputera dalam semua bidang profesional bertaraf dunia. Dengan kekuatan seramai 18,190 orang dari kalangan staf akademik dan staf pentadbiran, UITM telah memberi peluang dan akses pendidikan tinggi berkualiti kepada 165,668 anak Melayu dan Bumiputera dari pelbagai peringkat pengajian. Malahan, sejak ditubuhkan pada tahun 1956, UITM telah melahirkan seramai 661,456 alumni yang kini menjadi penyumbang terbesar kepada pembangunan modal insan negara.
Bumiputera Biggest University, University Teknologi Mara UITM has been ranked among the world top 500 higher education institution in the third edition of the QS Graduate Employability Ranking 2019. The UITM Vice Chancellor, Professor Emeritus Dato' Dr. Hassan Said said, the university had maintained its position as among the 301 to 500 world top tertiary institution. He added that UITM was ranked 4th among the local university with most employable graduates. UITM also showed improvement from reputation indicators among regional academic partners, which increased 10 places compared to 2018, which is proof that UITM graduates which are Bumiputera are very competitive and highly demand in Malaysia job markets. So, another Bumiputera figure that are well known in Malaysia since she was 18 years old, after she got 18 straight A's, and now she is working as a doctor with her specialization as a general surgery and trauma emergency in United Kingdom. At the same time, she worked at St. Mary's Hospital, Royal London Hospital, Chelsea and Westminster Hospital, and also Caring Close Hospital. This shows that these Bumiputera graduates are very highly demand and also competitive in international level, as her service and specialty are needed in 5 hospitals in United Kingdom. She is currently doing her PhD in medicine at the Department of Surgery and Cancer, Imperial College London, with a fellowship from Imperial College London and funding from NIHRU. Not to forget, in June 2020, 3 Bumiputera figure that pursued their study with sponsorship of the Department of Public Service, PSD, to continue their studies in Michigan State University, USA. They did not waste the opportunity to study at the Ivory Tower, even proving to be able to excel even in the foreign country. Due to their well performed, they received class of 2020 departmental award from the Department of Microbiology and Molecular Genetics, College of Natural Science. Thus, they surely prove that the Bumiputera graduates are also highly quality and very competitive in their profession.
Last but not least, after almost half a century of independence, after rule by foreign powers for a long time, the Bumiputera nation rise up and continues forge ahead and move according to its own identity, continues to work, creating a new history and higher achievement to become a competitive identity, not only in Malaysia, but also international level. Bumiputera figure who are famous in the eye of the world, both in terms of career and academic achievement, like Dr. Amalina, Dr. Sheikh Muzaffar Syukur and more, should be an idol and inspired more younger generation to reach glory.